In fact, it's generally believed right now that if there was a worse time for the CBI to try and give Mr. Kalmadi a clean chit, it was in the prevailing circumstances when corruption is already so much a national issue. Now, in my hand this evening, as I welcome my guests, is what we describe here at Times Now as the CWG file. This is 243 pages of hard evidence, hard papers, well investigated. And what has happened is that everything which was part of the Times Now expose is now being proven to be correct. The only difference is that the CBI is choosing to keep Mr. Kalmadi himself out of it. And as I said yesterday, this is 1 month of reporters' work on Times Now. The CBI has taken 25 times as long to come to the same evidence but derive the wrong, different conclusions. It's fascinating actually how the CBI is working. Meenakshi Lekhi is a Supreme Court advocate and BJP leader. Thank you, Meenakshi. D.R. Karthikeyan, former CBI director. Tehsin Poonawalla, political analyst and columnist. Hitesh Jain, Suresh Kalmadi's lawyer. Thank you very much. Now, Mr. Hitesh Jain, simple question for you. Is it possible that in one page... Now, I have also got this latest paper, which is the charge sheet, part of the charge sheet. In one page, this says that Suresh Kalmadi gave the approval for making exorbitant payments of 146,868.80 pounds to AM Films and in conspiracy with T.S. Darbadi and M. Jayachandran got the said payment release, Sanjay Mahindru got the said payment release. So, in one part of this, it says that Suresh Kalmadi gave the approval. It admits. And in fact, I'm sure you've seen the papers, Mr. Jain. This paper actually has Suresh Kalmadi's signature, if you go further into detail. His signature is right here. Maybe you can pan on it, he said. But in the next page of the charge sheet, it says that, you know, it just keeps his name out of the charge sheet. Aren't you surprised yourself, even as Suresh Kalmadi's lawyer, Mr. Jain?
Arnab, two issues are over here. We cannot decide in the studios what is the evidence and what are the arguments. The CBI over the period of 18 months have investigated the case and they have come to their own conclusion. They have filed the charge sheet and they will be submitting the charge sheet before the court. So I think we should allow the law to take its own course.
No, that is that I understand. I am not discussing and I am not discussing the what the courts will do. I am discussing the investigation, sir. I'm discussing the investigation, right? And what I'm pointing out to you is if the investigation had said, I want to get Meenakshi Lekhi and then I get your response. Meenakshi Lekhi, it's a unique situation. The investigation says that yes, Kalmadi approved the money transfer. But then it keeps Kalmadi's name out of the charge sheet. And when we are informally asking the CBI, how did you manage to do this? Is it a blunder? They said, no, Kalmadi, poor thing, had no time to apply his mind to it.
You see, he being the chairman of the OC knew pretty well how things were happening, and his own statement, if I remember correctly, when he said something to the effect that pickpocket has been picked up and the dacoits have been let off, and he was making the statement with reference to Sheila Dixit. And I want to remind Mr. Jain and the CBI director right now that Shunglu committee report was made available and was constituted under the auspices of the Prime Minister of this country, who himself is right now involved with coal scam. And in spite of Shunglu committee report and a strict indictment against Ms. Dixit, and in spite of all these evidence and papers available, they have chosen to ignore the evidence. And especially when he has approved, why has CBI not gone into the detail that how is it that everyone will take this kind of plea that I never applied my mind? It's not a question of applying your mind, it's a question of criminality, and criminality to the issue of corruption. And this gentleman, I think, made a statement before the court that he is suffering from Alzheimer's or Parkinson's or dementia, some such thing also.
Yeah,
so he is likely to suffer from dementia, and CBI is going to keep on making pleas on his behalf that poor fellow doesn't remember a thing.
Doesn't this destroy the credibility of the CBI?
We all know why, and No, the credibility of the entire government, you see, the what Commonwealth Games has brought to this country, we unfortunately, I mean, with so many good people in this country and such a beautiful nation, in spite of all this, we carry an impression that we have crappy infrastructure, we have a corrupt and dirty government, and this is precisely what we are painting ourselves to be by conducting
now,
the Commonwealth Games.
Now, I want to point out one more thing.
We have conducted.
I want to point out one more thing. It's important to put the past in perspective. In this file, Tehsin Poonawalla, in our favorite Commonwealth Games file, there's also a piece of paper, this piece of paper where Kalmadi's signature is there. Now look at this. What is the letterhead on which Mr. Suresh Kalmadi is signing this? You've seen this paper? It's the Crown Plaza Hotel address.
Yeah, yeah. I've seen it on your channel.
You've seen it, no? It's famous by now. It was after this that Kalmadi said we'll sue times now. He said it's all wrong. Now, Mr. Kalmadi is writing in
Crown Plaza should pay you for the branding.
No, it's all right. I have no problem. Mr. Kalmadi is writing on a hotel letterhead, please release the money to AM Films. What happened on the night of October 24, 2009?
Correct.
That Mr. Kalmadi released this payment. Was somebody putting a gun to his head? How does the CBI know that he was being pushed to the wall? All the people who are being blamed are people who are reporting to him. Can he, by any logic, can you present one logical argument why how he can be let off?
Yes, Arnab. The paper that you show on your channel very clearly says, what does Mr. Suresh Kalmadi write out there? Why so late now? You have left us with no choice. Now, Arnab, I would like to go into the details. So please give me time. Do not interrupt me. Before I answer your question, let me first tell Miss Meenakshi Lekhi that I have heard her. She's one of the leading lawyers in our country. And I've heard her speak on various channels. She talks for a free and fair trial. She says that there must not be a media trial. Then why does the rules change today when this is about Suresh Kalmadi?
It's too late to talk about media trial.
She incorrect when she spoke about Mr. Kalmadi.
It's too late to talk about media trial.
Kalmadi, on the contrary.
No, let me tell you.
Said that there was no such report. Please, Ms. Lekhi, I did not interrupt.
I'm Arnab.
Please, Arnab, now let me answer your questions factually. Please, now let me answer your questions. I needed to correct.
Okay, answer the question. I want one argument from you on how Mr. Kalmadi was led up the garden path by people.
The paper that you have shown, Arnab, sorry.
I have many others.
Yeah. So the papers that you have shown, Arnab, says where Mr. Kalmadi writes, why so late now you have left us no choice. Now, the fact of the matter is Mr. Kalmadi only reached there few days before this event was to take place. It was the London police that called for a meeting in the mayor's office, the mayor of London's office. The minutes of this meeting are documented and are present. This meeting was not attended by Suresh Kalmadi. The police refused to grant permission for the QBR unless extra screens or extra cars were bought in. This was a decision that out there, the organizers present had
great.
To take.
I take your argument.
Mr. Suresh Kalmadi only reached London after this meeting was
great.
Concluded. It was then
I
that
take
it was
your
brought
argument.
To his notice that the London police...
I have one follow-up question. Answer my follow-up question. So,
no, let me finish.
So,
no, let
once
me finish.
Let's reconstruct.
Let me finish.
Let's
no, reconstruct. Don't interrupt me, Arnab.
No,
I'm sorry.
Second,
do not interrupt
one second.
Me.
Hear the question. Don't be worried about the counter question. On CWG, I have the facts with me.
I am not worried about the counter question.
Here's the counter question. Here's the counter question. AM Films, because of this terrible last-minute hurry which the innocent Mr. Kalmadi got sucked into, was paid an exorbitant amount of money. My question to you is, was it the last time AM Films was paid?
No.
Why?
You're saying this decision...
No, I can understand.
I'm sorry,
why I'm asking you the question
you
is... Why I'm asking you the question is very simple. You make a mistake once because there's a last minute hurry. But then 3 months later, 6 months later, 9 months later, why is AM Films paid money again and again? Who's putting a gun to Mr. Kalmadi's
head? 14,000.
Yes.
14,000 pounds were demanded back.
If there's an outstanding payment, that payment has to be cleared to them. The fact was that they supplied the cars and they supplied the screens.
You're
you cannot deny that. And what is the cost? 1 crore 70 lakhs odd. This was approved by the ECB budget. If last minute the President of India is coming to London, if the Queen, if Queen Elizabeth is handing over the baton, okay, here comes the chairperson of the organizing committee. He has bought this last minute to his notice. London police threatened to cancel the event if screens and cars are not bought.
So,
what does he do in his capacity?
So,
yet he made his displeasure shown by asking why was this bought last minute?
So,
why was this not
beautiful.
Taken care of before?
Wonderful.
Are you trying to say that the London police, the London mayor, Suresh Kalmadi, everybody cahooted to have this whole little 1 crore little...
Don't try and divert the question. The London police is not paying AM Films.
How am I diverting? The London mayor called, the meeting was held in the office of the mayor of London.
The